Hey everyone, and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. So today we're going to be going over the origin, the insertion, and the action of the teres major muscle. So here we can see the teres major, and if we're to remove the muscle here, we can see the origin here in red. So the teres major originates on the inferior aspect of the medial border of the scapula. So the inferior aspect being the lower portion here, and the medial aspect being closer to the midline. And then obviously the scapula we can see right here. So moving to an anterior view here, we can see the teres major coming out from behind the scapula and inserting here onto the humerus. The insertion of the teres major is on the medial crest of the intertubercular groove, also known as the bicipital groove. And obviously you can see the insertion here in blue. So another interesting thing about the teres major is it's one of the muscles which could be seen from the skin surface. So we can see here, we've got the teres major, and underneath it you can see the latissimus dorsi, you can see the separation here, and the infraspinatus just medial to the teres major. One thing to note, it's a lot easier to see on this individual because they've obviously got a large amount of muscular development in their back, and also they're a low body fat percentage. So say you were working you know, your physiotherapist, you're working with a client or something like that, and they're a bit more overweight, less muscular development, you might not be able to see that from the skin surface. So we're back here again with the skeleton model, and you can see the origin of the teres major here in red, and you can see it originates on the inferior aspect of the medial border of the scapula. And if we turn the skeleton round, you can see the insertion here in blue, which is on the medial crest of the bicipital groove. So the bicipital groove is going to be a groove that comes up here, and it's where the long head of the biceps tendon sits. So if you imagine the teres major passing through here and it's squeezing, it's going to internally rotate the humerus as it squeezes. So we've got internal rotation as one of the actions there. Another action, if my shoulder's in a flex position and I squeeze my teres major, it's going to cause extension of the shoulder. So you've got squeezing that teres major, causing the shoulder to extend. And then finally, another action of the teres major muscle is if my arm is up here in an abducted position and my teres major squeezing, it's going to cause adduction of my arm. So you've got the squeezing of the teres major causing adduction. So thank you for watching. If you liked the video, you found it useful, you know which buttons to press those buttons, and I'll see you all next time.